release of the Tyre Nichols video, Memphis Police Director has not held any media events. That as her department is embroiled in controversy over what officers did and didn't do in the Tyre Nichols beating death. Tonight, WREG investigator April Thompson has more on the shroud of silence surrounding Memphis's top cop and why her boss, the mayor, says he's not worried. A warning, some of the video you're about to see is disturbing.
An update regarding
when Memphis Police Director CJ Davis briefed the Memphis City Council last Tuesday, it was the first time she went before cameras to discuss the state of her department. And she dropped some new bombshells. The investigation into the Tyre Nichols beating death has now netted not seven, but 13 officers who are either now fired or still under investigation.
We have looked at up to 12 disciplinary actions so far. As we continue to interview other individuals, we're also identifying whether it's a direct or indirect correlation between this incident and other administrative violations.
But for some, the question has become, where has the police director been?
One of the criticisms that I had of you as mayor was y'all were wrong. When the public didn't hear from you, the public didn't see you. The city council meeting cannot be the only forum where people hear from the administration. Because we have no authority over any direct authority over any division director.
WREG has continuously asked for an interview with Chief Davis, and we are constantly told she is not doing interviews right now. One person who is not worried, her boss, Mayor Jim Strickland.
So you think she has been as transparent as she should be with the public?
Absolutely. Last time I was here, she was with me.
Okay. I fixed to tase you! You don't get on the ground!
But that was hours before the videos of Tyre Nichols' interaction with police were released, more than 2 weeks ago. Video that has a country in disbelief and a police department still reeling as the number of officers entangled grows. But Mayor Strickland says his pick for top cop has handled everything well. Even as comparisons are made between the Scorpion unit she started in Memphis and one she was over for a short time in Atlanta. Red Dog was an anti-drug unit started in Atlanta to target drug dealers and street crime. But it was also plagued with accusations of violent tactics, beating down citizens, and of attacking people without asking questions. It was disbanded in 2011. CJ Davis was over Red Dog at one point in her career. But for many in Memphis, Red Dog didn't even come to light until the Scorpion unit's downfall.
The whole Red Dog issue, were you aware of that, and why or why was it not a problem for you?
At the time of hiring? Mm-hmm. No, I was not aware of the Red Dog unit or anything like that. But the little bit I've looked into it, that was a completely different kind of special operation than this. The Scorpion is more like the Titan unit that's currently in Atlanta. And Titan is completely different than Red Dog. Every police department has specialized units, but they do things differently.
But where both units were alike, officers out of control and accused or actually charged with excessive force. And CJ Davis had ties to both. In cases of the Scorpion unit, WREG has been asking the police department for how many complaints have been made against officers in the unit. We were told we have to give specific names of officers, yet police have yet to tell us who actually works in the unit. Even though Davis told City Council they do track excessive force within the special units.
And officers who have excessive use of force or other complaints, they've been moved out of those units. We have a list of officers that have been moved out of these specialized units because they just didn't fit the bill.
But it's information we haven't been able to get, even though the police director says they improved the process back in the fall.
We also changed our disciplinary process to capture all complaints in the Memphis Police Department. Prior to changing the disciplinary process, most internal affairs numbers or control numbers were issued by the Internal Services Bureau for investigation. Many of the complaints throughout the department did not receive a control number. We centralized all of our complaints so that we can capture the least complaint to the most egregious complaints in one depository through our ISB unit.
We asked the mayor about the complaint process.
We never heard anything about how many complaints they have. Is that tracked? Should it be tracked? And should it stop with the director?
It's
knowing that information.
Reimagining policing, all that data is on that website.
Complaints that they've had, IAB complaints, investigations that they've
had. Against the Memphis Police Department is all on that website.
And Scorpion Unit as well.
Included in those data.
So were you aware that there have been complaints against the Scorpion Unit before all of this happened?
No.
Apparently, no one had told the mayor about any complaints, though he and the police director have touted the successes of the Scorpion Unit.
It's easy to talk about the numbers and the successes, but should failures and concerns and complaints be a part of that information? Because some city council members said they had never heard anything else other than the rollout.
All those complaints, every one of them, is listed on the website.
But you had never heard of any complaints?
No.
We hope to finally get that information on who filed complaints and which officers were the subjects of them. And while we wait, Mayor Strickland is standing by the chief he brought in to make change.
You still have faith in her?
100%.
Always.
She has led this department the whole way through this ordeal. She immediately acted upon an employment situation that the city has never acted this quickly on. Our police department is as transparent or more transparent than any police department in the country.
April Thompson, WREG News Channel 3 Investigators.
Chief Davis also told the city council they will eventually release names of other officers once the investigations are complete. But right now, they are working with the legal department to determine the best way to do that.